It was one of those happening Saturday nights of Kolkata when I received that elusive phone call from Kumaresh. My friend from the jungle had made all the arrangements for me to travel with the honey collectors into the jungles of Sundarban. I grabbed my backpack and headed towards the mystery land. It was like homecoming for me. Familiar images were passing by me. And as my boat passed by Razia's village, I couldn't stop myself from paying my friend a short visit. Voila! The small sleepy village was suddenly alive with a great festive mood, and I realized somebody was getting married. I was quite embarrassed at my carelessness of not being prudent enough to inform my host about my arrival. But generosity is a way of life around this place, and the family were more than happy to have me as their guest. My eyes were looking for Razia when one of her younger brothers informed me that it was she who was getting married. I couldn't have had arrived at a better time. For the rest of the ceremony, I could only hear Razia sobbing. And all attempt to see her once proved futile. The marriage party left with the bride, leaving behind a gap which was not hidden from my eyes. It was a double blow for Razia's mom, parting with the daughter and parting with the provider. Razia was the only member of the family who was earning through her handicraft work, and she left a vacuum which was difficult for the family to fill. I moved on in the late afternoon towards Sundarban, and again reminded myself that I had come to this place with a definite purpose and wouldn't let myself divert from it. But old habits die hard. My curiosity took better of me. Like me, all the passengers of the boat were suffering from the afternoon heat, but there was a set of people who, without being bothered, were indulged in a peculiar act.
কি করছেন দাদা এটা
এটা মাছ আমি ধা দিচ্ছি
তো এর মধ্যে কি মাছের বাচ্চা আছে
হ্যাঁ
এরম না করলে কি হবে
মাছটা মরে যাবে
এটা কোথা থেকে নিয়ে আসছেন আপনি
নোহাটি থেকে
নোহাটি তো অনেক দূর
হ্যাঁ ওর তিনটে থেকে
এতক্ষণ থেকে আপনি এরকম করছেন সুন্দরবনে এরকম কিছু নেই হ্যাচারি
Pre-dawn of monsoon had coincided with the marriage season in Bengal, and I was not surprised to find my friend Kumaresh at one of the marriage ceremony. The extensive rain left us indoors, planning and replanning our strategy of Project Honey Collecting. I wanted the whole thing to be done in a very orthodox way, and for that, I had to wait for yet another day. I was wondering, how could I pass my day, when the children and women folks of the village took me to their own small expedition.
Oh, didi, kuchhen?
Bagta bachi.
Bagta mane hoy bagta chingri.
Chingri, pin bagta, bagtar bachcha.
Koto kore na eta?
80 taka hajar. 1000 tulle 80 taka.
Koto khon lege jay 1000 tulte?
Though the dangers of running into a tiger was remote in this case, but more than often, these small professionals were on the bed suffering cough, cold and fever. I was later informed that they did this twice a day because the high tide happens twice and the pin bagda is found in abundance at those times. And both the timings were peculiar, one in the afternoon and the other midnight. These meager amount of money earned by them will help in the family cause. They were the unsung heroes of everyday life in this part of the world. The ill-timed rain gave me a bit of time for getting my plans straight. It was simple. I would cover all aspects of honey collecting. The first stop was the Sajnekhali forest office, where the honey collecting team had to get their permission. And I got the shock of my life at this place. The authorities informed me that I could not enter the jungle since I was missing one relevant paper. Here I was ready with the team, equipment and the courage to go to the jungle. But a piece of paper was stopping me from doing so. Disappointed, I made a quick change in my plan and decided that the only aspect of this expedition which I would miss would be the actual cutting of the honeycomb. So I thought I would cover the rest of the aspects. Sundarban is a mysterious place, but Royal Bengal tigers makes it even more intriguing. A species which has survived all the odds of this treacherous place. Only the salt water to drink, it has mastered all the arts of survival in these mangrove forests. Though shy, it doesn't hesitate attacking humans, and the honey collectors are the most vulnerable lot. Lalu, the team leader, informed me about a woman whom they visit every year just before the expedition to get a special blessing from her. It is believed that if you have this with you, the tigers will never come near. As this was the starting point of the travel, I thought there couldn't be a better start for me than this.
Didi, apni je kagoj ta dicchen, ei likhe je apni dicchen kagoje, eta diye ki hobe?
Bag jate akrom na pare jara jay jongole.
Ha.
Tader akrom na pare.
Ha.
Tai jonno proti bochor eta dao.
After the team was armed with the woman's blessing, they started their travel and promised to take me as far as they could into the jungle. The next stop was the mangrove forest itself, where they performed a special ceremony to mark their start of journey, the worshipping of Bono Bibi. Although this goddess is believed to be Muslim and most of the honey collectors are Hindus, she is revered by one and all.
Hello.
তার কাছে কাছে থেকে যান।
এই শুনো না, শুনো না,
it was a charismatic scene for me, and words are not enough to explain the feeling that I had at that particular time. My team leader informed me that this is the farthest they can bring me, and I had to retreat. The next 6 days would be a trying time for this team. The whole day would be spent in honey collecting, and the whole night guarding each other from the tigers. And that sentence is no indication that the attack cannot happen during the daytime. It was a long wait for me, and I thought I could use my time to find out about a sad but interesting fact that the newspapers keep on writing about from time to time. Vidhuapulli, or the widow village. And this is what the locals had to say.
বেশি সংখ্যক জেলে যখন বাস করছিল, বেশি সংখ্যক মানুষ জঙ্গলেও যেত। জঙ্গল ছাড়া যখন কোনো গতি ছিল না, মরি বাঁচি করে জঙ্গলে যেতে হবে। বারবার বাঘে খেয়েছে আর বিধবার সংখ্যা বেড়ে গেছে। এই কারণে ওই বিশেষ অঞ্চলটাকে বাইরের লোক বা যে কোনো জ্ঞানী মানুষ যেহেতু একাধিক বিধবা দেখছে, তাই বিধবা পল্লী হিসেবে পরিগণিত করেছিল।
এই মুহূর্তে বিধবা পল্লী নেই, সময়টা অনেকটা অতিবাহিত হয়ে গেছে। ফলে সেই বিধবারা, তাদের মধ্যে অনেকে মারা গেছে, অনেকে কাজের সন্ধানে হয়তো ছেলে বাইরে পড়াশোনা করে কিছু করে সেখানটা চলে গেছে।
আর তারা পঞ্চাশ কলকাতা সব কাজ করতে হয়েছে, এই জন্য বিধবা পল্লীতে এক জায়গায় পাওয়া যাচ্ছে না।
ওরা তো সবসময় মানুষকে পাচ্ছে না, শুয়োর পাচ্ছে, হরিণ পাচ্ছে, মাছ কাঁকড়াও বাঘ খায়। কিছু অংশ যেটা দর্শনার্থী এবং যারা মাছ ধরতে যায় তাদের জন্য যেটা খুলে দেওয়া হয়েছে, সেখানটা এত বেশি প্রোটেকশন এবং এত বেশি পলিউশন, সেখানটা কিন্তু বাঘ বলুন পশু পাখি তারা কিন্তু সেটাকে অ্যাভয়েড করছে সব সময়। যে
ইন দ্য এন্ড আই হ্যাড মোর কোয়েশ্চেন্স দ্যান আনসার্স। প্রবাবলি দেয়ার ওয়াজ আ প্লেস কল্ড ভিধুয়াপল্লী, অর প্রবাবলি ইট ওয়াজ জাস্ট দ্য ইমাজিনেশন অফ ফিউ লার্নড পিপল হু ওয়্যার কোইনসিডেন্টলি জার্নালিস্ট। হাউএভার আই থট আই কুড ফাইন্ড আউট অ্যাবাউট দিস মাইসেলফ সামডে। Exactly on the seventh sunrise, the team returned, and I rushed to meet them. The joy on their faces told me that it had been a successful trip. And later the honey-laden barrel proved it. It was a collection of 700 kilos, but sadly, around 150 kilos had to be given to the forest office at a very low rate. The team had escaped the claws of the tigers in the jungle. But out here, there was no escape. Along with the money, the team had to give away a portion of wax to the forest office as well. And I had the chance to see the whole process of wax making.
This is the pure wax. A lot of hard work is involved, and this looks like chhena through which you can make rasgullas. This looks very tasty.
The next destination was selling off rest of the honey to the buyers. After all the mathematical calculations, I realized that each member of the team would take home an amount of rupees 5,000, equivalent to around $100, and for this they wait the whole year, take all the risks, and then again wait for the next year. When I realized that I had nothing more to cover, I asked my leave. When Lalu suddenly came up with a plan, it went like this. The village itself had few honeycombs, and Lalu suggested that why don't we go and cut those honeycombs exactly the way they do it in the forest. Hmm? This was the only part missing, and I was more than happy to oblige. The next morning, we went to the site, and suddenly they were not the same people I knew. It seemed something took over them, and they were totally absorbed in their work. The masks they wore were designed to deceive the tiger. Normally, the tiger attacks from behind, and the honey collectors wore the mask behind their head, thus confusing the tiger. These masks are being provided by the forest office, but Lalu told me that the tigers were much more smart than to be fooled by these childish masks. Everything was going on smoothly when hell broke loose. Even before I could realize, at least 1500 bees were on my face and body. I started running towards nowhere and getting the bites in the process. One of the bees entered my ear, and then I lost all the power to think. The excruciating pain compelled me to take off all my clothes and jump into a nearby pond.
This is what happened. I just went into the pond and I come out to get the state of my lips. One of the bees went into my ear. I'm in a bad shape. I've got to go and visit a doc.
When I returned to my friend's place, I looked something like this.
What's wrong with my body? Look at my lips. I got at least 25 to 30 bites.
It was a mutual mistake of my team and myself. They didn't give me any protection, and I was not wise enough to ask for it. Anyhow, we realized our mistakes and decided that we will go once again, but we'll take all the care. That night, I had a fit of vomit, diarrhea, and high fever. The next morning was fixed for the operation. Though I had been courageous enough to commit myself into it once again, when I reached the site, I could feel the paranoia inside me.
This is the ingenious plan that they have done to protect me from the mosquito bites that I had to tolerate yesterday, and I hope it doesn't happen today. Just keeping my fingers crossed.
When a person calls a bee mosquito, you can easily sense how tense he can be. The operation started and went off well. Just two bites in my share and one in my assistant's share. Lalu told me that during those 6 days of expedition, they got stung at least 10 to 15 times every day. In the end, I was left wondering whether the endeavor of these honey collectors was worth it. Though I was satisfied with what I got and returned to Kolkata.
He wants more money just because the size of the bee is too big.
Four days after the bee had entered my ear, I finally got it out of my body. but the experience I had in Sundarban would be with me all my life.